I don't know what made me do it, but I started doing a striptease in the dark, thinking that my wife is going to enjoy this. I guess I was a bit horny, so to speak.
He was making all this noise, and then all of a sudden, it got quiet. So I reached over to grab my lighter. I was just gonna flick it one time, just to get a little bit of light in the room, just so I could quickly look to see where he was. When I clicked the lighter, the next thing I know, I just saw a whoosh of flame right in front of me. And I heard my husband go,
"You know, when I saw that ball of flames, you know, it went from being, you know, excited to being in total, you know, in total panic. I was shocked. And I smelled hair burning. And the room was lit up, but there wasn't any lights on.
What is it with that smell?
Immediately, that's when I could smell hair burning.
I don't know. I can't even look down.
And then when she really looked at it, she said, "Oh my gosh."
Oh boy. He was in trouble.
What is it, honey? What do you see?
Okay, Glen, I don't want to panic you. But it appears you've been burned down there pretty bad.
That's when I knew. It's time to go to the hospital.
So before we left, she called my folks up because they had the kids, and she said to them, "I'm taking Glen to the ER. He got a burn on his leg." She didn't go into any detail. In the meanwhile, my dad had called my aunt, who worked in the ER, and said, "Look out for Glen, he's coming in. He got burnt on his leg."
I'm telling you, if my aunt sees me, I'm gonna die. You have no idea how tenacious she is. You have no idea.
And the first person we see was his aunt.
Glen.
And, you know, she looked at me and she said, "What happened?"
"So what brings you to the ER, Glennie?"
And I couldn't tell her that my wife lit me on fire.
"Do you need me to take a look at it for you?"
Not only was I burnt, you know, it was really humiliating.
His face was as red as his...
"No, I'm okay. Thanks, Auntie."
And I definitely did not want her to see what happened.
"The doctor's ready to see you."
"Okay. I'll see you later, Aunt."
"Bye. I'll catch up with you later, Glennie."
Once I was in the room and the doctor had come in, I had that robe on and he asked me what happened.
"Okay, so I understand we're experiencing a burning sensation."
"You could say that."
"Okay, well, I have to ask, when was the last time you had a STD check?"
"It's not that kind of burning."
You know, I was still didn't want to show what happened, so I just said, you know, I had burnt myself.
"Okay, well, let's have a look, shall we?"
He wasn't sure what that meant, and I just didn't want to show him.
"How did this happen?"
I didn't even want to talk to anybody, honestly. I just wanted someone to make it feel better.
"You have a really bad burn on your groin area, Glen. I'm gonna need to call in a specialist."
"Specialist?"
"To see how we should proceed."
And then the doctor tells me he has to bring a specialist in. And, you know, I said to him, I said, "Doc, is this thing really serious? Am I gonna lose my jewels?" You know, and basically he just looked at me and said, "I don't know."
"You know, you have some really bad blisters that could lead to scarring, permanent disfigurement, the possibility of you not being able to get an erection again, you know, and then, you know, you also have some burns on your rectum, which could lead to a couple months of incontinence. And worst case, you know, we could be talking about amputation."
"Amputation? Hello, I'm Dr. Graham. You're lucky you came in while I was still on duty." "Hi, Doc. Can we just get some burn ointment so we can get out of here?"
"I'm gonna have to check the area before I can do that, but I can promise you we're gonna get you out of here as quick as we can."
Yeah, but I wasn't sure whether they were gonna amputate it or not.
Oh,
I thought they were gonna take it off.
"You don't amputate your penis. We'll just get you a new one. We'll get you a bigger and better and a newer model."
"No, we'll get you a new one."
"Okay, let's take a look."
The look on his face was more concerning to me than anything else, because now I got afraid looking at him.
"All right, if you want me to help you, you're gonna have to tell me exactly what happened."
I couldn't say I spilled coffee on me because I had no hair. So I told him, I said, you know, I said, "Doc,
if you need to know, I was just practicing my dance moves."
my privates went up in flames.
I see blistering, first degree and second degree burns.
You know, as it turned out, the reason that I had burnt the way I did was because I had spilled alcohol on me. And, you know, it definitely was the cause of this working as an accelerant to give me the burns that I got.
The good news is, I don't think a skin graft will be necessary.
That's good.
What about the bad news?
The bad news is we're going to have to lance those blisters. There's always a concern of infection.
No!
I mean, I sob it up like this.
Stay with me, Glen.
I mean, I was completely sober, I was completely aware, and I was completely in pain. And I was completely embarrassed.
One more, Glen, one more. And that's it. That's it. We're gonna bandage you up, and after you're bandaged, you're gonna be good to go.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Oh, you're welcome.
Well, after we found out that he was gonna be okay, I still had concerns.
So, no performance issues down there?
No, I don't think so. I think you should be pretty much back to normal.
I wanted to make sure we could have a healthy sex life as a married couple. Yeah, I was concerned.
Provided there's no infection. And Glen, I'd like to give to you a going away gift, an antibiotic cream that you must put on the affected area 3 times a day for 2 weeks.
Most burns take about 6 weeks to completely resolve.
For a burn on the genitals, you're not gonna wanna have sex for a while. That burn's gonna be incredibly delicate, and it's not the kind of thing you just wanna roll the dice with.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome. Take care, you guys.
Thank you so much.
Don't go too fast. My boy still needs some healing to do.
You did good.
You did good, too.
You're so brave.
You're brave.
Well, Glen, looks like you caught a lucky break this time.
Please, Aunt Linda, don't tell anyone else in the family.
Oh, your secret is safe with me, Glenny boy.
Thank you.
Bye.
We'll see you later.
I'll see you guys at dinner on Sunday.
Okay.
We're having flaming hot chicken wings.
Oof, no.